Glad to have you.
What's up, guys? I'm YKF31 here, bringing you game two of season number one of my UConn Offline Dynasty. Game number one went well, took care of UMass in my season opener, and now we take on the Maryland Terrapins at the Wrench. Game number two in our non-conference portion of our schedule, and we take a step up in class. Maryland provides us with some difficult challenges. They're led by C.J. Brown. And C.J. Brown is one of the dark horse dual threat QBs in the country. A guy who's had his career marked with inconsistencies due to injuries and being inconsistent. But when he's on, he is as good as any run-pass threat in college football. The UConn offense was clicking on all cylinders against UMass. Defense showed some troubling signs. And with the level of competition amping up, we'll see if we can right the wrongs on defense and continue our good vibes on offense. And there is the aforementioned C.J. Brown. Wes Brown is a running back. And Stephon Diggs, he is their big play receiver. So offensively, they're going to show a multiple offense, pistol, shotgun, pro-style formations out of an up-tempo pace. And there's Stephon Diggs making it happen. The UConn defense really has to start adapting to this 3-3-5 stack scheme, or it's going to be a very long season. And right on cue, UConn shows some great rallying to the ball on the flats. Coverage held, didn't allow C.J. Brown to scramble, was forced to check it down, and we held it to a minimal gain. And now here comes Maryland's tempo. Brown demanding a spy. Checks down to Dave Steinbaugh, who breaks a tackle, and we allow the first down. Gotta have more consistent tackling than that from the UConn defense. Maryland going tempo, went from shotgun to pistol. One of the advantages of this 3-3-5 stack scheme is that you're pretty well equipped to handle these type of spread no-huddle attacks and multiple no-huddle attacks if you have really dynamic and versatile safeties. And there's C.J. Brown, shows off his wheels. Time to stop bending and get a little bit more aggressive. And the big guy, Shamar Stephen, the big nose tackle, he will deck Wes Brown in the backfield, and Wes Brown is down and not getting up. So we have one Brown out of the game. If we can knock out C.J. Brown for the game, we'd be in good shape. But Brandon Ross steps right in and converts the third down on the screen as we're a little bit too slow to react. This is the area of the field where we need our two best offensive players, Ymir Smallwood and Byron Jones, to step up and make something happen. Getting more aggressive now, bringing some heat, and right on cue, Byron Jones gets beat over the middle. He's the best cover safety that we have. He's got to play better than that. Wilbert Lee, the safety on the other side to your left, he's more of the run-stopping enforcer. Brandon Ross tearing through the defense, third and short. UConn in week one struggled for most of the first half to get UMass off the field on first down. Maryland now tempoing out of I formation. Third and short, looking to bring some heat. 3-3-5 split, double B gap blitz. Graham Stewart's going to come in free, forces the hot read, and Byron Jones makes the great wrap-up tackle for a loss. You bend but don't break. See the pressure coming in free. Byron Jones steps up, makes the great wrap-up tackle for a loss. So we will hold the Terps to a field goal attempt. Kick is up, and it is good. Now, as troubling as the defense was at times in week one, the offense showed a lot of promise. Chandler Whitman was nice and efficient. All the receivers got involved. Jeremy Davis had a big day. Shaquem Phillips did some nice things as the vertical threat. The true freshman slot receiver. Damir Bradley showed some great potential. And Lyle McCombs ran very well as well. Lyle McCombs getting started, running behind the strong right side of the line that we have. McCombs should put up big numbers in this offense. shifty, agile, elusive, quicker than fast. And out of the spread offense, we will look at tempo on every first down and big play. Looking to get Shaquem Phillips involved a little bit earlier this game. Jeremy Davis was the big play guy in week one. Phillips was kind of quiet. He's the fastest guy that we have on offense. Looking to get him the ball in space. Look to hit him on the move, on some bubbles, some mid-screens. Let him use his big play ability to make plays happen after the catch. UConn showing a good rhythm so far early. Chandler Whitmer also threw the ball very well week one. He even ran it halfway decently, even though that's not his strength. Looking to dial up some play action here on third and short. Whitmer getting everybody in the right play, in the right position. Protection busts, and we will get sacked and have to punt on our first drive of the game. Not a good sign. Maryland defender comes in completely untouched. And Whitmer does a good job not to fumble. All right, defense back on the field. A three and out would be lovely. Not a good start on getting a three and out as C.J. Brown goes to strike it over the middle, back at work, and now he's going to scramble. Converts another first down, gains about 10 yards, going right down the field.
And he's tackled right away.
And we are putting up very little resistance. And now the defense has to defend its red zone yet again.
Brought down.
And the UConn D is going to fail miserably as C.J. Brown takes it in on the read option. And Maryland just runs right down the field and cuts through our defense like a hot knife through butter. That was disconcerting. Two possessions and Maryland has scored on both and we're down 10-0. Now the offense has to respond. And Chandler Whitmer hits Sean McQuillan. Bit of a forgotten man in week one. A talented receiving tight end, not much of a blocker. But he's a weapon in the passing game. Chandler Whitmer throws another stretch to Shaquem Phillips. Now the UConn offense is on the march. UConn absolutely has to get points on this drive. Can't turn the ball over, can't lose yardage, can't put the defense back on the field without having any points put on the board. Going back to the ground to Lyle McCombs. He's only 5'8", 166 pounds, but he's more than capable of handling the load. Lyle McCombs again, doing some jitterbug running for a first down. Third and four. Jeremy Davis over the middle. He pays the price, but comes up a little bit short. We're going to put the sure points on the board. Now we just need the defense to stem the bleeding a little bit. We're going to go to the studio, and we see UMass being a little bit pesky against number 18, K-State. It'll be interesting to see how that score holds up. All right. Defense has got to do something. They got to stop the bleeding. And Brandon Ross gets to the corner and picks up 4 yards on the first down. And then goes around left end. Maryland is making this look effortless, but we finally step up. Wilbert Lee crashes down on the inverted veer and gets us off the field. Big play. Desperately needed that turn of events. McCombs with a nice move in the backfield to get it to a nice 10-yard gain. Huskies looking to tie this sucker up. While McCombs out of the backfield, another first down, or close to it, third and one. Chandler Whitmer sensing that he has to carry this team. With another strike to Demir Bradley. Impressive march down the field by UConn for the second drive in a row. Demir Bradley again, the freshman with two key catches. And Chandler Whitmer keeps on the option, and UConn is knocking at the door. Looking to punch this in, and Lyle McCombs does just that. The defense did their job, and the offense was able to cash it in, and we got a tie ball game. All right, Huskies, let's keep them off the board going into the half.
He's gonna try and scramble.
C.J. Brown with room to scramble shakes Byron Jones. Byron Jones having a very inconsistent first half. It's looking like we're going to have to do some serious recruiting at the safety position. B.J. McBride was able to flush him out a little bit, but there was no contain. And C.J. Brown is good enough to make you pay. Brown looking to pass again. B.J. McBride does some good work against the left tackle, but he's able to gain 4 yards, and he comes right back and throws a strike on the post route, and that will give Maryland a 3-point lead going into the half. C.J. Brown is just a one-man band so far. We got to find a way to slow him down.
Just as easily been a touchdown.
A tight first half of football, and we head to the break. The Terrapins with a 3-point lead. Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. Ball security was a major theme coming into this game, and both offensive coordinators have to be thrilled with the fact that their offenses, first and foremost, did a good job of taking care of the ball.
And you don't see it every game, that's for sure, that both teams don't have a turnover at the half. And you usually see those critical mistakes that set up a short field for you to take advantage of. And it's definitely nice. It's nice to be able to put in a plan all throughout the week and to be able to execute it and not to be able to make those big mistakes. Because coaches will tell you, it's those big mistakes that kill you. It's okay to be rushed in the pocket as a quarterback and then throw it to your mom in the third row. Don't throw it in harm's way. Both quarterbacks done a good job, and as a result, both teams with zero turnovers in the first half.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. Got a good, like a good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. They stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
All right, so this game has a very shootout-like feel to it. And as I say that, Lyle McCombs gets dropped for a 4-yard loss. Chandler Whitmer hanging in the pocket until the last possible second. It's Jeremy Davis for a manageable third down conversion. And we just barely convert. Chandler Whitmer busts out the zone read. Critical third down given how the defense has been playing, and Shaquem Phillips with a tough drop. Tough sideline catch, but that's the catch that you expect your big play go-to receiver to make. That puts tremendous pressure on the UConn defense, which cannot allow a touchdown and make this a 2-possession deficit. Making Maryland's punter see the field would be a very great thing. We're in a bit of a bind. We don't cover well enough to be as aggressive as I would like. And Brown scrambles well enough to need a spy. On third down, Yawen Smallwood makes the kind of play that your impact player has to make. We should get good field position out of this punt. Taylor Mack gets us across midfield, so we're in business. We have a golden opportunity here with good field position to be really aggressive. We're going to bust out some play action. Sean McQuillan over the middle again. Great ball handling by Chandler Whitmer opens up the throwing lane. We get a big gain up the middle. Dialing up play action pass off the zone read. Let's see if we can get a defender to bite. Whitmer with the play fake. And Shaquem Phillips gets wide open at the back of the end zone. Tremendous display of ball handling by Chandler Whitmer on this drive. Shaquem Phillips with his first touchdown reception of the season.
If you're the corner,
zone read play action fake freezes the defender. He bites on the play fake. And Shaquem Phillips gets wide open to the back of the end zone and makes the catch.
Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update. Iowa and Iowa State hook up in the battle for the Cy-Hawk Trophy. And for Iowa, they scored through the air. The Hawkeyes lead it by 7. By their defense.
Uncle Mo is wearing a blue and white helmet. The blue and white helmets give up a completion to the flat for 9 yards. The Husky defense looking to build on that last possession. Impressive series of downs as they stepped up when they needed it the most. Going to bring Byron Jones on the blitz. Zone read.
He has some room.
And C.J. Brown converts. And a major coverage breakdown. Goal line defense, C.J. Brown to speed option. Wilbert Lee and Jefferson Ashiru gang up and hold the edge. Great play by Jefferson Ashiru and Wilbert Lee. They were able to get him just before he get the pitch off. Third and goal. looking, too much time, and Tavon Jacobs makes the reception. Back on the ground to Lyle McCombs. This has the look of a game of either the first mistake will lose it for somebody, or whoever has the ball last will win it. Jeremy Davis on the reception. Chandler Jones having another great day throwing the ball. Jakeem Phillips continues his big game. Another big reception. It's still early in the season, but this has the look of a year where the offense is going to have to carry us. Zone read. Kendall Whitmer. Lyle McCombs. Great display of teamwork and hustle by Lyle McCombs. After he receives the fake, he heads downfield and springs the key block to let Chandler Whitmer get into the end zone. Not the most crushing block in the world, but it was just enough. C.J. Brown dropping back. Stephon Diggs. We have not been able to disrupt his rhythm as a passer or contain him as a runner all game. Once a talented quarterback gets into a rhythm, it's very, very hard to get him out of it, especially if it's established early. Byron Jones sticks his nose in. Having an up and down game. At that time, he was up.
He's making too many plays. I mean, he's that close to the line of scrimmage.
Good stick. We get him off the field. Cover one blitz. Taking a chance, showing press coverage. Speed option, and no one accounts for the quarterback. That's a killer. Third down again. And we finally get an incompletion. Fourth down, Maryland is in that college football no man's land. Too far for a field goal, too close to punt. They will go for it. Yawan Smallwood spying. He stays at home. The 11th tackle of the day for Yawan Smallwood, and none bigger than that. The Huskies will take over, and now will come a healthy dose of Lyle McCombs. We're going to run to the right side behind our best blockers, and we're going to see if we can grind out a drive, get some points, and leave not a lot of time on the clock. McCombs cracking 100 yards. Again, key third down here. Third and four. And a questionable call by the coaching staff on third and four. A hideously executed triple option. Even Herbstreit is calling out that play call. Not well done. Poorly blocked, poorly executed, and well defended. That could come back to haunt. Play action. All day, and there's to go C.J. Brown yet again. This is like a poor man's Johnny Manziel performance here. B.J. McBride gets some nice pressure, but he's too slow. And we get hurt over the middle. Dialing some five-man heat, and a great throw and a great catch. That is just a heck of a play, both by the quarterback and by Stephon Diggs, to make the catch and stay in bounds. This is probably four down territory at this point in the game. Second and 10, it's not going to matter. Byron Jones gets beat again, and Maryland is back on top. A very tough day for Byron Jones as C.J. Brown clutches up on that drive. And UConn's just going to have to win this with their offense. With no two ways about it. But Taylor Mack, he gets a crease on the kickoff return. He could go 50, 40, 30, 20. Does he have enough? Taylor Mack will house it. 106 yards to the house. Big play by Taylor Mack. He's been getting beat like a drum in coverage all day, but steps up with a huge kickoff return for a touchdown. And now all these defensive troubles could be erased and forgotten about with just one stop. Can UConn get it? We try some cover two. We allow the completion up front. Yawan Smallwood closes. At least it wasn't deep down in the seam or up the middle. At this point, we're just scrambling, searching, trying to vary out looks, do something, anything to get C.J. Brown out of rhythm. Cover one with a spy. B.J. McBride with some pressure.
He chucks it downfield.
And a terrible, terrible display of coverage. Williams commits the cardinal sin and fails to locate the ball. And gives up the big completion, and now Maryland is back knocking on the door. Gotta stop him. Gotta find a way. B.J. McBride with a hard inside rush. Forces the short throw over the middle. You got a spy on C.J. Brown. Three-man rush. Yawen Smallwood steps up and forces the incompletion. Fourth down. Risky coverage. Slot safety blitzing. Linebacker jumping out to cover their slot receiver. And that's just enough confusion for Terrence Mack to close and tackle the receiver before the first down marker. So we escape. We find a way. UConn goes to 2-0, 31-27 once again. Chandler Whitmer was the man. The defense was scary. You see C.J. Brown with 437 yards of total offense and three touchdowns. But we find a way. We find a way to man up and get the W. 2-0, and next up is Michigan. Hope you guys enjoy. Talk to you all later. Peace.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Street, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.